More signals incoming. Come on, team.
Don't get too comfy, okay? Stay frosty, Marines.
Move on!
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Last support required.
Hang on. Our ride is coming.
Move on.
Got something on the tracker.
I have multiple signals.
Don't get too comfy, okay?
Move on! Hurry up, you slugs!
Don't get too comfy, okay?
Quiet. Too quiet.
Come on, team! Got something on the track. More signals incoming.
Don't get too comfy, okay?
Move on! Stay frosty, Marines.
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Move on! Got something on the track. Multiple signals. More signatures spotted. Move on! Multiple signals.
On my way! Let's see what's inside.
Let's see what's inside. Move on! Let's see what's inside. I have multiple signals. More signatures spotted.
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Come on, team!
Don't get too comfy, okay?
Move on! It's quiet. Too quiet. Move on! Got something on a tracker. It's quiet. Too quiet.
Stay frosty, Marie.
Team!
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Team! Got something on a tracker. Last support required! Hang on, our ride is coming. Too quiet. Move on! Stay frosty, Marines.
Don't get too comfy, okay?
So, hostile critters, a wiped out colony, Hunslet being Hunslet. How'd you find your first day in the Corps?
I don't know. It's a lot to take in.
If it helps, you're doing okay.
Thank you. I'm glad it's over. My nerves are shot.
Oh, it ain't never over. But for now, we got some time.
Good. Gives me a chance to work on the comms. If only we could hear from Director Price and Pharaoh Spire. We could use her help.
Dr. Becker's been trying the whole time we were deployed. It turns out most long-range transmitters are down. If someone's home at Pharos, they probably can't pick up. Do you think those things can be there too?
Judging by what happened on Pioneer, it's clear that they're spreading extremely fast.
Then you'd better get familiar with the Otago right now. We can't give those creatures the benefit of time.
This one's a priority. Understood.
Administrator, I wanted to... Oh, going that badly, is it?
I'll get back to you on that. Can I do something for you?
Actually, yes. I was hoping you might persuade Sergeant Harper to retrieve some samples of the creatures. One can never have too much information about one's enemies.
I didn't know you worked in corporate espionage, Doctor.
Very droll. On the other hand, I do find that science and skullduggery have a surprising overlap. Both require focus and a keen eye for detail. One supposes.
True enough. And you're right. We need more information on these things. I'll talk to the sergeant. Chief Engineer Corrigan, isn't it? We met before.
Oh, it's you. Sorry about that,
You had your hands full. Things look better now.
They are. Came together faster than I thought. Ain't pretty, but we're functional and I hope stable. Harper told me we got splashed after some kind of failure in the planetary quarantine protocol. Something called Cerberus?
That's what's going around, certainly.
More corporate corner cutting. What a fucking mess. Anyway, I should be able to produce equipment for our Marines now.
Anything I can do to help?
Well, I don't think this ship will ever be spaceworthy again. But that doesn't mean we have to abandon her. It could be shelter, you know? For these people. For us. The only problem is dear Otago took a beating. I got holes to patch, cables to reconnect. Our cryo chambers, our shield, they're history. In short, we're missing materials. Spare parts to turn into upgrades for both our guys and the ship.
Look, no promises. But we could ask the Marines to check for materials in Dead Hill storehouses during their next visit.
It all helps.
Administrator Hayes, what brings you to my corner of the Otago?
Sergeant Harper says I should take a look around. He's probably trying to keep me busy.
Yeah, the devil loves idle hands. I can't give you a tour. We're still digging through the wreckage.
How does it look?
Well, we've more portable weapons than we've got Marines to carry them. So if you find anyone out there with training, you point them in my direction. As for the ordnance, it's pretty much scragged.
What about the emergency escape vehicles?
That satellite relay idea of yours, huh? Yeah, Harper told me. If we can get the fuel linkages repaired, we might salvage one EEV. But I'd be damned before I let you play with the only life pod we have left.
And how useful is a single life pod on a crashed ship, exactly?
Yeah, you're pretty convincing. I'll give you that. All right, take it. But keep me updated. This one won't let you down. What did I teach you, Marine? Salute! This one won't let you down.
salute. This one won't let you down. What did I teach you, Marine? Salute! This one won't let you down. What did I teach you, Marine? Salute! This one won't let you down. What did I teach you, Marine? Salute! This one won't let you down.
Back from your tour? How'd it go?
Pretty good, I think. Dr. Becker requested some samples of the creatures for study, and Chief Corrigan is in need of components to turn this ship into a proper base.
I thought you were all about getting your message out.
There's nothing to say we can't do the one so long as it doesn't endanger the other, is there?
True enough. All right. Let's go back to Dead Hills. I have a feeling we missed something there.
The same feeling you have when these creatures come around, Sergeant?
This is hardly the moment, Deputy Administrator.
Listen, Sergeant Harper. Your abilities, they could be tied to this outbreak. If there are more like you out there, it could help. People should know. They have the right to
know. You mind your own business, Hayes, and I'll take care of mine. You have a relay to find and I have men to lead. We both have a part to play. This conversation's over.
New objectives are awaiting your review.
This one's a priority. Understood.
Hello, Administrator Hayes.
What did I teach you, Marine? Salute!